Welcome to Grab & Go Info. This tutorial will talk about how to make time series anomaly detection using Facebook Profit Model in Python. Anomalies are also called outliers, and we will use these two terms interchangeably in this tutorial. After the tutorial, you will learn how to train a time series model using profit, how to make predictions using a profit model, how to identify outliers using a profit time series forecast. Let's get started. In step 0. Let's talk about the algorithm for time series anomaly detection. At a high level, the outliers are detected based on the prediction interval of the time series. The implementation includes the following steps: build a time series forecasting model, make predictions on historical data using the time series forecasting model, compare the actual values with the prediction intervals. Outliers are defined as the data points with actual values outside of the prediction intervals. In the first step, we will install and import libraries. iFinance is the Python package for pulling stock data from Yahoo Finance. Profit is the package for the time series model. After installing iFinance and Profit, they are imported into the notebook. We also import Pandas and NumPy for data processing, Seaborn and Matplotlib for visualization, and mean absolute error and mean absolute percentage error for the model performance evaluation. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue with the tutorial. The second step pulls stock data from Yahoo Finance API. 2 years of daily data from the beginning of 2020 to the end of 2021 are pulled for this analysis. Start date equals 2020-0102 because January 1st is a holiday, and there is no stock data on holidays and weekends. End date equals 2022-0101 because iFinance excludes the end date, so we need to add 1 day to the last day of the data end date. The goal of the time series model is to predict the closing price of Google's stock, so Google's ticker GOOG is used for pulling the data. Profit requires at least two columns as inputs, a DS column and a Y column. The DS column has the time information. Currently, we have the date as the index, so we reset the index and rename date to DS. The Y column has the time series values. In this example, because we are predicting Google's closing price, the column name for the price is changed to Y. Using .info, we can see that the dataset has 505 records and there are no missing values. Next, let's visualize the closing prices of the two tickers using Seaborn and add the legend to the plot using Matplotlib. We can see that the price for Google increased a lot starting in late 2020 and almost doubled in late 2021. In step 3, we will build a time series model using Profit in Python. Notice that we did not do train test split for the modeling dataset. This is because the goal of the model is not to predict future stock prices. Instead, the goal is to fit a model that predicts well on the past prices. Therefore, we will use the whole dataset for both training and forecasting. When initiating the profit model, the yearly seasonality and weekly seasonality are explicitly set to true, and then fit on the training data. The interval width is set to 0.99. which means that the uncertainty interval is 99%. We keep the model simple in this example to focus on the process of anomaly detection. If you are interested in building a sophisticated model, please refer to my previous tutorial, Multivariate Time Series Forecasting with Seasonality and Holiday Effect Using Profit in Python. After building the model, in step 4, we use the model to make predictions on the dataset. The forecast plot shows that the predictions are in general aligned with the actual values. We can also check the components plot for the trend, weekly seasonality, and yearly seasonality. In step 5, we will check the time series model performance. The forecast data frame does not include the actual values, so we need to merge the forecast data frame with the actual data frame to compare the actual values with the predicted values. Two performance metrics are included. Mean absolute error sums up the absolute difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. Mean absolute percentage error sums up the absolute percentage difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. MAPE is independent of the magnitude of data, so it can be used to compare different forecasts, but it's undefined when the actual value is zero. For more time series performance evaluation metrics such as mean squared error, root mean square error, median absolute percentage error, and symmetric mean absolute percentage error, please refer to my previous tutorial time series forecasting of Bitcoin prices using profit. The mean absolute error for the model is $31, meaning that on average the forecast is off by $31. Given that Google's price is in thousands, the prediction is not bad. The mean absolute percent error for the baseline model is 1.7%, meaning that on average, the forecast is off by 1.7% of the stock price. In step 6, we will identify the time series anomalies by checking if the actual value is outside of the uncertainty interval. If the actual value is smaller than the lower bound or larger than the upper bound of the uncertainty interval, the anomaly indicator is set to 1. Otherwise, it's set to 0. Using value counts, we can see that there are 6 outliers out of 505 data points. After printing out the anomalies, we can see that all the outliers are lower than the lower bound of the uncertainty interval. In the visualization, all the dots are actual values and the black line represents the predicted values. The orange dots are the outliers. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about time series forecasting, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.